Alright, I turn my microphone back on, guys, just so I can chat a little bit. Right now I'm just cleaning out some manure from the barns. Me and Jake played a little bit last night for MP and sold our bales from our other beef farm at the northwest side of the map, and made some money off of that. And I don't know, it seems like every time, I didn't lay the, it was 550 some odd square bales, and didn't lag my game when I looked at them. It lagged my game when I would drive into the bales with the forks to, you know, pick them up. And I used that automatic bale stacker to load them up and dump them next to one another. And I think what the issue is it, that bale stacker allows you to overlap bales one another, and I think the collisions get intermixed or intertwined, and so when you go to load one bale, they all start moving and swaying and, you know, acting really funny, and the game really bogs down. So I think what the issue is, it's that bale stacker. It gives you the option to stack the bales too close to one another. So what we'll end up doing is probably just manually, we can still use a bale collector, but I'll probably just use the telehandler to stack them in the shed. And instead of going 8 high, I'm only going 4 high with the bales now, just a little bit easier. You can see our liquid manure tank. Basically, I eliminated the old one and I just made it a fill plane instead. So the fill plane goes up and down. And we're at 65%. So, still has a way to go. It's a lot of liquid manure in the lagoon. So this guy just sold. I also didn't like the how quickly these calves were fattening. They would fatten one mature for every 5 that you have, or 5 minutes, or what, I don't know what it was, but then I changed it to 1 for every 10, and then 1 to every 20, whatever ratio it is he's using, and so it seems to be a little bit more realistic. We're doing 50 or so every 3 hours. So this is our new new purchase we got on the farm. Had this tractor for a while, but we just picked up our DB60 planter. 24 row, individual row units that flex, cylinders all line up. So the wings flex and the row units flex on it. Ridge markers do not flex. I'm sure I can get them to flex, but. I just didn't really see any point to it right now. Also, this one had the lift arm as mouse controlled, just to give a little bit more control over how it handles, how it folds, basically really depends on the hitch that you're running, what kind of tractor you're running on the hitch, how low it is to the ground, how high it is, so you can level out the planter. Nice little touch. Next project that, because I think I'm going to be doing beef and dairy, like working with animals for a while before I go back to crop farming, just because I'm having a lot more fun doing this. It's more interesting than just doing soil management. This is allows you to, you know, work with animals, hay, use the forage harvesters, use the manure. At the same time, you can also do soil management, but it's not the biggest aspect of the farming. I'm going to use some different equipment as well. And I built this 450 because all the, you know, the T8s are too small, and the, you know, 600, 500 horsepower tractors, they're all, you know, they're too big. So went with the 450. New Holland, just because I really like blue, not necessarily New Holland, it's like the blue. Raphael redid his tires and slapped on some new fenders. I mean, the bottom is existing, and then you just kind of like make a new shape and overlay it on a blue UV, so pretty easy to do. I swapped pipes, used the KSIH pipe, flipped them around, half suspension cab, just so the driving experience is a little bit better, and, you know, little features like moving seats and hoods and doors. So it's a really enjoyable tractor to drive, nice and smooth. Definitely going to be our planting tractor, and it works really well. To pull the manure, the solid and liquid. Basically, it's a lot heavier. It's 24, 25 ton machine versus a, what is a T8? I don't know, like 16 tons maybe. I don't know, so give or take, it's probably 8 to 10 tons heavier than the T8. More horsepower, more torque. So it handles the 37,000 liters of liquid, you know, at 8 pounds a gallon, and it's what, 7,900 gallons or something like that. So, you know, it's a pretty heavy load to try to handle. So there's the train. 60 cars. We pretty much bought this planter off of selling all of our hay bales. It was, I probably moved 150 or so straw bales. No, it was 45, 45, and 45. But I used probably half of those on putting straw back into the barn. So like 140, 185 bales I moved to this farm, and then we had probably another 400 or so left, and had Jay come on and help me, and we loaded the rest of those up and sold them. I mean, it was interesting because I never used any bale trailers before, so I had to do some work on bale trailers because they're pretty tippy, and you know, they're just poor conversions, not completely converted with the scripts, and you know, the support arms wouldn't even function or move. So, did some work on those, and have a nice step deck bale trailer. So on this field, I planted the grass. This new soil mod allows you to plant grass now without destroying the field, so you don't have to always plow up the field when you plant grass. So it's like the same thing as alfalfa. Drive our trucks back so I don't have to. So I'm just gonna cheat a little bit. Cut through here. Should have turned off traffic. I don't really like how the traffic is in this game. It, like, in 13, you can just, like, move them out of the way. You know, and it wouldn't do anything. But these cars are, like, impenetrable. I don't know why they did that. I don't know why they changed the traffic system. You know, like the milk truck. I miss the milk truck. I miss being able to move these, you know, vehicles out of the way. And I'm like, you had to redo entire traffic splines. I mean, it doesn't make sense. There's nothing wrong with the old traffic, and I mean, it worked well, it had no issues. Then they went ahead and changed it, and all that occurred was they made it worse. You know, there's nothing I've seen they improved on. I only see things that have become worse. So I mean, that's unfortunate when they try to make changes. You regress. So of making this road paved, because I use it so often, and it's kind of like a branch off of major connection. So I think this would actually be a decent road to turn into a paved. Farm on the hill has a little lake or pond. It's nice to have this map fully developed now. Use all four corners. It makes the map seem really big when you have to drive from one side to the other, you know. And enjoy the views all the way, you know. Put all the time and effort into making these trucks and trailers and other mods, so it gives you a chance to enjoy the driving experience and the views in the map. So stop it and say National Beef. Too far. So, in order to fill your mixer wagon with mixed rations, you need to actually do more than just add forage to the fill type. There is three lines where it's like silage, grass, straw, like 0, 25, 25, 75, or, you know, something like that. What you do is just copy and paste those, you know, lines, and you put it from 0 to 100 and you change it to forage, so there should be 4 lines instead of 3. That allows you to actually fill the mixer wagon with your forage. So it's not just as simple as adding it to the fill type. I mean, you need to do that as well, but it's not going to work if you just do that. You know, because it's a mixing wagon, it needs to have a ratio of mixture for the fill type, otherwise it won't work. So I just say you can fill this thing up from 0 to 100% with forage. So 8,000 capacity on this bucket. Makes quick work. I don't know why all these vehicles, like, why they scripted the game for when you're loading something, it starts to rock, like, it's an earthquake. I don't understand that. It's not really realistic. I don't know if I have to increase, like, a lateral stiffness on the wheels, like on the semi-truck, so... This guy's... full. I want him to go about 45. We'll load horse. Hopefully he makes it back on. So what are you guys saying? I like your channel, can you buy dairy cows? Do you make all your mods? Yes, I can buy dairy cows. Yes, I make my mods. Sometimes I edit other people's.
I like your channel.
Do you need to buy new cattle to feed them and make them fat and then sell them again? Yes. So, if you were to go...
Yes, I can buy dairy cows. Yes, I make my mods. Sometimes I edit...
See here, you can buy the calf in the store for
$800.
Or, you know, piglet for $450. But,
I need to buy a new cow to feed them and make them fat and then sell them.
When you go and actually go to National Beef and buy them like I've been buying them, instead of paying $800 for a calf, you're paying $600 if you were to actually physically go and load it. So instead of, you know, and you're selling your beef for around like $1,200, $1,300 per mature beef. So you're selling for $13 and you're buying for $600. Or you can just buy in the store for $800. I mean, it's $200 more. That's $200 out of your profit, but it makes sense if you're selling just to bring some back. So this trailer holds 50 mature and 100 calves, so basically if you want to maintain your same level of cows, just buy a trailer for every two that you sell and it works out fine. I was around 3,200 beef cattle. I still have probably, I took out a $900,000 loan to buy land, equipment, and cows. So I am slowly trying to grow my facilities at the same time, pay off my debt. And we bought a new planter, we bought more beef, and paid off like $300,000 of our debt, so I have about $300,000 more to go until we're completely paid off and have a positive net worth again. But this new beef farm, it's probably the most realistic layout. It has an old farm, and then it's kind of like that was the old initial farm, and then they built more modern facilities up on the, you know, further up on the hill. And, you know, this land around here is basically ideal for crop farm. Only downside is basically to get to any sell point. Oh my gosh, will they make it? Nice. To get to any sell point, you have to cross the train. So sometimes that can be a little bit of a hassle when you're running course play and you're trying to do like great demands, and even while doing this, selling beef. That's another dairy farm up on the hill, fully functional. It has no pastures though for the animated dairy cows, but it has all the same triggers for the animal husbandry, manure, liquid feeding. It has milk triggers as well, so you can do a dairy up on that on the hill, as well as the dairy over there on the by the lake, the more modern, larger dairy facilities. But this has a grain complex, moisture meter, moisture check. I changed all the doors and gates and everything to the animation door trigger, the new one that was built for 15, and it works a lot better in multiplayer. And with the old one, I would have to open up a door for Jay, because like if I opened the door, it wasn't open for him because it wasn't an animation of the map. So with this new trigger, it really, really helps us out. And they stay open too until you close them. So that's either a positive or a negative, depending on what you are looking for. Animated some nice roll-up doors. So I have wheat or barley in that field and grass in this field, and it's the only two fields we own right now. Did the bigger one for grass just so I can either chop it for silage or bale it in case my fermenting silage are full. So there's our step deck bale trailer with just a little bit of our straw bales left over in our big hay shed. So these are big fermenting silos. You put your silage in, or your chaff in, and it comes out and it ferments in there, and it comes out as silage. So the only difference of this bee farm versus the bigger feedlot down on the northwest is it doesn't have any silage mountains. It just has two fermenting silos, so you really can't hold that much silage here. I mean, it's like 500,000 liters of silage, but you really don't need that much silage if you're also using hay and straw. But in these bunkers, I just have three. I have mixed ration, silage, and hay, and then straw. I just leave as bales. So this guy reached his destination. So the whole concept behind this new version 5 of the pig and beef mod is the fattening aspect and the market. So you sell mature beef and then you buy it, like you buy smaller calves. And you have to put some triggers in the trailers and such. But I like it. It's a little bit more interesting than just doing dairy. I mean, it's essentially the same thing, same feed, same equipment. The only difference is you get to actually buy and sell beef. You know, it's a lot more work than just doing dairy. This has milk cell. This map has the milk cell triggers as well, so you can actually like fill up a trailer with milk and you know sell it at the dairy. But it will, you know, the price doesn't really fluctuate, and it will sell at midnight anyways. So the difference is like when you buy a dairy cow, it stays there; it doesn't disappear. Where if you buy a beef cow, it fattens because you're selling it for meat, and you sell it. Same with the pigs. so it only costs you money if you want to keep growing. Otherwise, you pretty much do, you buy a trailer for every two that you sell if you want to maintain your same, production levels. But I'm pretty sure we're going to get to the point where we just want to sell the rest of our beef and get into more crop farming in this map, in this location, and maybe keep 1,000 head. To have something to do in the, you know, when the crops are growing. Because you fast forward time, you're always having beef to sell, beef to buy, they need food, they need straw, a lot of manure, liquid manure. Otherwise, crop farming can get kind of boring when you put down all your nutrients and you have to fast forward, you know, 16 days to get to like a harvest state. So. Kind of studying the Oxbow Windrow mergers, the 33-foot merger. All right, so here I see it's $604 to fill, versus $800 in the store. So you're saving $200 by coming here and buying. And then Farm to National Beef. Like we're done feeding cows. Sprayer, I absolutely hate the sprayer. So ugly. So, still quite a bit of work to do on this map. Need to finish developing the town on the other side of the road. Need to finish putting in power lines on the northeast side of the map around the lake, and finish putting power lines down to the farm I just built, and power lines to the dairy farm on the hill, and down to the far west side there's power lines that need to be built. Few things that need to be adjusted and such, but overall it's nice to have a mostly completely developed map finally after over a year of working on it. Started in 13 and did a lot of work this year in 15. So it's nice to finally enjoy nice high frames per second with such such detail and view distance. And, I mean, if I get out, you can see pretty far. I mean, I jump out of the truck here. Now you have a pretty good view of the farm on the hill and more of the dairy farm. Nice view of the crops without that little annoying bubble. Just increase the view distance. View of the wind turbines, the town. So this guy is ready to sell. So, I mean, I've been doing crop farming for so long, and, you know, I like the equipment. I like the big tractors, big tillage tools, big planters, combines, but it gets kind of boring after a while. You need to just kind of, like, change, have a change, and maybe I'll get back into it. So I think we bought enough cows to get back up to where we want to be. So not much going on here except just buying and selling, so.